Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates.
Let's be brave. It's all love needs to fuel the fire of you.
Alright, we're all set to go, which means turning off the air conditioning, getting into reverse. Okay, reversing assistant, please get me out of this parking lot right now. Oh, handbrake is down. Yeah, now you see, I think I've already shown you this party trick so many times, but it is always so hilarious, but it's also very stupid a feature because, I mean, unless and until you're parking in a designated spot, but removing a car is easier, parking it is the difficult part. Anyways, right now we are in Eco Pro mode. There are four drive modes actually. There's adaptive in this particular car, which is basically it adapts a lot of things, like of course the dampers, the steering wheel, the engine and the gearbox, and probably the air conditioning as well. And we are straight away going to get onto this road, which has kind of bad patches. I mean, this is the worst road on earth, to see how is the ride quality of the car. And trust me, I'm already sweating because the suspension is on the stiffer side and the ride quality is far from being great. You can see, you can feel a bit of it here as well. And I have to curtail my speed because the ride quality of this car isn't impressive at all. Oh my God, it actually crashes through. Plus, because of the extremely low profile tires, you have to be very careful because you don't want to damage those M rims either. Steering is actually light. It's easy to twirl. Yeah, it's extremely light, extremely easy to twirl. And the only problem is just too chunky. It's too big a steering wheel. That is the only issue you will face. Otherwise, the steering is kind of on the fine side. At least at low speeds, you don't face any problem whatsoever. And being a BMW, it obviously weighs up at high speeds. Only thing is not very direct as such. Ground clearance isn't an issue. Twin axle air suspension means air suspension at the front as well as the rear, which is not there in this car. It is optional on the M Sport. It is standard on the X Line trim. Now, what exactly does it do? Well, obviously, it can alter the ride height, and that's the reason you don't have those buttons in the center console, because there is no air suspension in this particular car. However, being the M Sport, it gets M adapters. Yeah, that's why it has that adaptive function. So running on steel springs, which is actually a good thing for handling, but not so good for the ride quality because of the stiffness of the springs, which you can feel over bad roads. Now in Eco Pro, you can feel that there's a brick in front of you, especially when you switch modes. Now you realize that in Eco Pro, it dulls the performance dramatically. It has a coasting function as well. It tries to just increase the fuel economy of this car, which it doesn't manage to do to a great extent. In Eco Pro, it's more efficient. However, it will return between 6 to 9 kilometers per liter, which isn't great fuel economy. They should have given us the X Drive 30D, a diesel. Oh, why am I being so compromising? They should have given us the X Drive 50D actually with 4 freaking turbochargers. Yeah, that's right, 4 freaking turbochargers. That's when power kicks in, yo. Now, this is the least powerful version of the X6, which is available in India, which makes no sense to me at all. Now, driving in Eco Pro is stupid, so we'll get into comfort mode. Comfort mode gives a good balance between economy as well as performance, and adaptive as well as comfort have the exact same instrument cluster display. And on the gas, you can see the performance is very good, but for this price, you definitely expect more. Now, I can't really differentiate much between the clusters, basically in the comfort as well as the sport modes. They could have really varied it even more on this car. As you see, performance is more than ample. The engine is sporty enough, but for this price, well, you needed more grunt. The 50i should have been offered minimum. 50i should have been there. So that's basically a lot of expectations from a car which has actually set the benchmark of what a coupe SUV, horn is nice, should be in the first place. See, the ride never settles down, it's always busy. It's time to get into sport mode, sport for the gear levers, sport for the traction control system as well. And now left foot on the brake, right foot on the accelerator, launch control active. Holy moly, the way it shifts gears is absolutely unreal. This car snaps gears like it's nobody's business. Super fast gear shifts. This 8-speed gearbox is so lovely, I can't tell you in words. It just shifts gas in a jiffy, but unfortunately because of the low profile tires and the ride quality, you have to actually slow down over rumblers as well and just lift off, not to load the front end. The gearbox is like, that's how fast it shifts. It's mind-blowing how good this gearbox is. Fantastic. And of course, you can manually take control of things using the Triptronic function as well as the steering mount paddles. And as soon as you get into sport mode, now in the heads-up display, now I see the tachometer, I see a line there. That's so good. Now it will not downshift in manual mode, which is actually a good thing, but you know what, we shall downshift right now. Here we are. Immediately pounces ahead, right? Just like gallops ahead. That's the kind of performance on offer. Now it will not upshift unless and until you do so. 7000 RPM is where it's redlining. I can see the heads up display flashing telling me upshift. Okay, we will upshift. You will not torture this 3-liter straight six motor anymore. But that is lovely. In spite of having the Chinto engine which we have here in a big car, it still is very impressive in terms of the way it performs, which is really very nice. So it gives you complete manual control of things, which is fantastic. And of course, sport mode is the one to drive in. But in sport mode, trust me on it, it's just too aggressive, it's just too pouncy, it's just like eager, madly eager, it just wants to gallop ahead. That's kind of crazy. Now this car obviously gets M specific brakes, which means that braking performance is absolutely stellar. Super duper awesome brakes, stops dead in track. The motor is quite refined but becomes super sporty in the mid-range, and this is a car which has grown throughout the rev range. It is so fantastic the way it performs. I love the engine, I love the response. Every time you get into the gas, it makes a downshift so fast. This gearbox is godsend. Trust me, this gearbox is godsend. It's so fantastic. The engine is so good. Okay, we'll just delete that. Anyways, you see the performance is stellar here. You know why? It produces 335 horsepower between 5500 to 6500 RPM. That's the reason why the top end is so lip-smacking awesome. The way it upshifts, the way the engine pulls, and the way it revs is so good. Now, of course, this straight six motor deserves endless praises. It's done duty in a lot of BMW cars. However, in the X6, it kind of slows it down. Okay, 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 5.5 seconds. That's kind of slow. And the top speed is restricted to 250 kilometers per hour. Obviously, it will go ahead of that as well. You know why I'm not so impressed with the X6 in terms of the performance? I mean, the engine is fantastic. But for a car of this size and its weight, it weighs, I think, 2.2 tons. You need a bigger engine. Now, of course, they have bigger engines on offer, which unfortunately not offered in India. Drivability is great because that 450 Newton meters of torque comes in at a low 1500 RPM. And such a wide torque band peaks at 5200 freaking RPM. My goodness, that's absolutely wide. What an engine, what a sound. BMW knows how to tune the exhaust on its cars. Okay, I know, the M50s and all, they have a fake exhaust note. Yeah, that hurts. So, here we go. Little bit loss of traction happens. But right now, I'm not turned off traction control. The reason I'm not turned off traction control because then launch control won't work. And even with the traction control off, you don't feel anything because it's got X-Drive, which means four-wheel drive system works fantastically well, offers great amount of grip, and the tires are so wide. They're so wide. It's obnoxious that how wide tires are there on this car. Okay, supercar wide tires on this car. But then when you come to such a road, you realize that, okay, fine, you're driving an SUV, but you really cannot up the pace here. You have to actually slow down. And that's a bit of a bummer. Because, yeah, the ground clearance is fine. Now, obviously, because it doesn't have SS, you can't raise the ride height of the car. It's kind of disappointing, but because of the steel springs, I think this car actually handles better than the one with the air suspension, because the air suspension is soft and cushiony. So here you, I mean, the handling is better, but the ride quality goes out for a toss in that way. But hey, I'm not complaining, because every time I wonder all this, I get it on the gas and my goodness, this engine, the way it revs is satisfying to an entirely different level. What the f- is he doing? ये हॉर्न बजा रहा है, ये क्या कर रहा है? Lost sight of what I'm doing. I just got lost in the performance of this car. It's so good. It's so good. But at least for India, since this car is a CBU, they should have given us more powerful engines. I mean, this is the equivalent of a Mercedes AMG GLE 43. And even Mercedes is now offering a 53 instead of a 43. So why is BMW offering us such a low spec engine, maybe for cost reasons, because they're like, you know what, we need to price it aggressively. This one costs 12 lakhs more compared to the equivalent X5 with the same engine, the 40i. And yeah, 12 lakhs more for less practicality and just better looks, which is also subjective, by the way, makes me wonder, should you actually go ahead and buy an X6? Because it also misses out on a lot of features, which are all of them are actually optional here. Braking performance is really nice. You'll see this adaptive braking happening here. Yeah, that is called adaptive braking. Oh, look at the G-force we hit, 0.6G. And the hazard light is also turned on. Fantastic, absolutely fantastic, the engine. Great low-end punch, great mid-range punch, absolutely fantastic top-end. How can you put power and torque onto the reference BMW? Tell me that! It's just everywhere you go, everywhere you dig deep into the powertrain, it just has enough to give you, and more than enough to give you. That is the level of performance. But then I realized that the cost of this car happens to be ₹1.13 freaking crore! Yeah, that is very expensive for what it offers. On-road Mumbai, of course, the pricing. CBU comes by the CBU route. But when you're doing CBU, you could have offered us more performance. I think BMW strategy was, let's offer an entry-level X6. Meanwhile, we'll give them the X6M. And then X6M will obviously be totally bonkers. So this slots right in between the X5 as well as the X7. The X7 is also like around that only. The pricing is similar for the base diesel variant, which is the DPE, Design Pure Elegance. However, the M50D is almost 2 crore rupees on road Mumbai. So yeah, BMW is trying to offer a lot of, you know, variants. But with the X6, they're being very conservative, because the last generation of the X6 was actually available with a diesel engine, which I've driven, and look, both of us look obnoxious, both the car as well as me here. That said, what a fantastic engine. This engine made me forget the lack of features. It made me forget the obnoxious looks and the lack of practicality and all those things, because this engine is so freaking stellar. What an engine. And handling characteristics also pretty nice. Yes, there is body roll on offer. There's quite a lot of body roll on offer actually. But with the steel springs, it somehow works better. But it's just so unsettled all the time. It's never cosseting. It's never like, okay, now I've settled into the good ride quality, now you can enjoy. No, it's always on the move. The suspension never settles in. And that's a bit of a problem, because our roads are always uber covered, and you always kind of feel something or the other happening under your ass, and you're like, I've paid so much money and I still don't feel comfortable. That's kind of weird. Somehow, you know, it doesn't let you feel its weight. It is big, but that's what she said. It's a car which you enjoy driving a lot, as far as you're on good roads. On bad roads, you just have to be careful. So, you know, your average speed turns out to be the same, because you're like pushing on good roads and you're really slow on bad roads, and you realize, I could have had a better ride quality on this car. But you can actually opt for air suspension, because that's optional. BMW will take all your money by giving you an optional kit. There's so many optional bits on this car. It's absolutely staggering. Like, I think you can double the price of this car by opting for optional kit, and basic stuff is missing, which is again optional. It's kind of weird, and I just don't understand the strategy of BMW. Like, this is the X6. This is the X6. This should have all the freaking pictures. So guys, this is my vlog on the BMW X6 M40. No, what are you saying? It's M Sport. It's not an M50 or an M40. It's actually X Drive 40i. Fantastic as a car, but not really practical. This is a car you buy by thinking from your heart, I meant heart. Okay, not from your head. And in that sense, it's fantastic. But if you start thinking practically, well, the X5 just makes so much more sense, because, well, the X5 does all this and more, with even more panache. And on that bombshell, it's time to end. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this vlog, make sure to give the thumbs up, that's the like button, and also subscribe to the channel. I can listen to the soundtrack every day. It is so good. I've never ever launched a car so many times in a vlog, which I've done with this car, because the soundtrack is so freaking awesome with great traction levels. In fact, we need to do it once again, and here we go.